Hello, everybody. So back to our series. We saw in the previous video how you can manage an app once it is in Azure AD. In this video, we're going to see how you can actually go and migrate off ADFS altogether and move all the authentication to Azure AD. For this demo, let me recap the end user experience. If I go to the app in a fresh session, I see that I'm going to ServiceNow, then it redirects me to Azure AD. When I type in the username, it redirects me to ADFS. And the reason it does that is because the domain rcdemos.net is still configured to be federated with ADFS. So let's say I'm ready to validate how can I authenticate my users without ADFS in the picture altogether. So let me switch gears and go to my admin portal. So I'm wearing my admin hat. I only want to show you that I already have turned on this feature called Stage Rollout. Okay, so what that feature allows me is to try cloud out authentication with a subset of users in that domain that is configured for federation. So here I can see that it's already turned on for password hash sync. Ahead of time, I set up Azure AD Connect to synchronize the password hashes while keeping federation in place. That doesn't change the user experience whatsoever. Now, when I go here to manage groups, I'm going to show you here that I have this group called Cloud Auth Transition Pilot. And at this point in time, there's nobody in there. So what I'm going to do is to add this test user we've been using for all these demos. So I'm going to add this user. As you can see, the user has been added. And at this point in time, we have to wait a couple minutes for the change to take effect in the backend. All right, so a few minutes went by and the backend process completed. So I'm going to try to get into my application again. And the difference here is that since the user is now enabled to use stage migration, when I type in the UPN here and I click next, instead of going to ADFS, I see the challenge of the password being happening in Azure AD. So I type in the credentials. So for the end user, it's exactly the same password they used to type in ADFS, but now it's in Azure AD. Click sign in, and I just move straight to the workload without having to go to ADFS at all in this flow. So what we've seen so far is still a hybrid approach where we are using the AD on-premises password. Let me show you one more thing. I already have here a browser window. I'm going to log in with the same user, but this time around, I'm going to choose a security key to authenticate instead of a password. So in this case, I choose a FIDO key with a biometric sensor. I'm going to put my fingerprint in, and I go straight to the application, totally passwordless. So in contrast with our previous flow, this is not hybrid. There's no dependency on Active Directory. The credential itself is fully managed in Azure AD.
Let's recap our journey so far. First, we start by discovering and classifying applications with the help of Azure AD Connect Health and the ADFS Application Activity Report on Azure AD. Then, we migrate our first application using a script that reads ADFS configuration and then create the Azure AD applications. We can migrate at scale our SaaS apps to Azure AD. And then once the applications are in Azure AD, we can manage them and benefit of all other features in Azure AD like user provisioning. Finally, we're able to cut the cord with ADFS and move authentication to the cloud.
Luis, that was a great summary to see all the diagrams putting the entire journey together for our viewers. So let's talk about some go-dos.
Yeah, so tomorrow, check if you already have license to use Azure AD security features. You might find a sweet surprise. Remember that single sign-on with Azure AD is free. So start thinking a plan for connecting all your new apps with Azure AD. Also, install Azure AD Connect Health and use the ADFS Activity Application Report to help you discover your ADFS applications.
In 1 month, make sure that you sync all the users and groups for the applications to Azure AD so you get ready and prepare your ground for that. Migrate your first SaaS applications and get familiar with all the capabilities of Azure AD after you configure the single sign-on. In 6 months, go and start thinking about your migration at scale and also plan your passwordless journey.
Well, this was great. Thanks so much for sticking with us through all these videos. Ramiro and I, we hope that you get some learnings out of this. So thank you so much for watching.
Yeah, thank you, Luis. It was fun to shoot these videos with you. And folks watching, if you are interested in more content like this or any feedback for us, please make sure that you follow the links on the description below to let us know. So thank you so much and see you in the next series.